You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already listed the criteria that if you want to be amongst the righteous and the pious, don't think it will happen unless you sacrifice from that which you love. If you love something but you know it's haram, it's something that will displease Allah, it's wrong in the sight of Allah, it will anger Allah, give it up for the sake of Allah. Because if you give that up for the sake of Allah, if you sacrifice it, that's when you're going to obtain pure sincerity, pure piety and righteousness.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulillah. Rabbi shahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlal 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli.
MashaAllah, though you have the masks on, I can see the smiles behind those masks, MashaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase you all, bless you all, and accept all of your acts of worship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us all in paradise. You see, the brothers and sisters who might be next to you, the neighbors that are next to you, are not just your neighbors right now praying, they're your neighbors in paradise as well. So become friends with them. If you walk away from Taraweeh, if you walk away from this Ramadan not making a new friend, you've practiced Ramadan incorrectly. You've practiced this beautiful gathering incorrectly because you haven't made a new friend. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite us all in paradise together. Say ameen.
Ameen.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. You see, my brothers and sisters, in order for you to succeed, for you to have success, you have to learn to sacrifice. Amongst you all, who would like to be where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angels consider you amongst the righteous and pious? Put up your hands. Oh, he doesn't want to, mashallah. But the rest of you do, mashallah. He has two hands up. This is the criteria of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, which will lead you towards righteousness and piety.
لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ.
You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already listed the criteria that if you want to be amongst the righteous and the pious, don't think it will happen unless you sacrifice from that which you love. You see, Habil and Qabil is a perfect story of sacrificing from that which was the best. Habil and Qabil go back to a fight, was the first fight and murder that happened on this earth. And what was it over? Of course a woman. Love. And they were asked to make a sacrifice on a specific mountain. Habib takes his best thing that he loved the most to sacrifice it for the sake of Allah. While Qabil took something that wasn't so good to put it on the mountain to sacrifice it for the sake of Allah. As you can imagine, you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. When you want to sacrifice for the sake of Allah, sacrifice the best that you have. Oftentimes when we think of sacrificing, we think of money. As we should, it's very normal. It was the time of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there was a war about to take place. And he called the companions, he said, everyone bring some charity, bring some money. Let's fund this war that's about to take place, this battle. And guess what happens? Umar bin Khattab that day, radiallahu anhu, says, I'm going to outdo Abu Bakr Siddiq today. Today's the day I outdo him. So he comes to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, giving half of his wealth to the Messenger for his sake, for the sake of Allah. Sacrificing from that which he loves. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam asks him, what have you left for your family? He said, I have left what I've given you, meaning half. Here comes Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and he just unloads all of his wealth for the sake of Allah to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam asks Abu Bakr Siddiq, Ya Abu Bakr, what did you leave for your family? He said, I've left Allah and His Messenger, and that is it. We are not asking you to sacrifice everything that you have, but whatever you do decide to sacrifice for the sake of Allah, to obtain success, to obtain paradise, just know it has to be the best. If you want to sacrifice just that $1, that's okay. But just make sure that you give it with a lot of love, a lot of sincerity, a lot of consciousness of Allah, that Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Rabbi, I'm giving this for your sake. And guess what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully aware of what you give. He knows if you're giving the best of the best. He understands and is fully knowledgeable that if you just gave something that will obtain Him from a place of love, that you gave it for the sake of Allah. But I don't want you to think that sacrifice only means money. No, it also means your time. Sometimes you have to sacrifice the phone conversation when you're sitting with your family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that you love that. You love to be on it. You love to do something. But your family came first. You did it for the sake of Allah, and Allah is very well aware of what you just sacrificed for His sake. Sometimes right now we're in Taraweeh, the most beautiful month of Ramadan. There's other things that you guys could have been doing, but you didn't do it. Why? Because you sacrificed for the sake of Allah. When you sacrifice for the sake of Allah, that is the only way you will obtain piety and purity. So if you want to become pious and pure, you want to really perform the tazkiyah, the purification of the heart, then sacrifice from that which you love. If you love something but you know it's haram, it's something that will displease Allah, it's wrong in the sight of Allah, it will anger Allah, give it up for the sake of Allah. Because if you give that up for the sake of Allah, if you sacrifice it, that's when you're going to obtain pure sincerity, pure piety and righteousness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to record us amongst those who are pious and have piety and righteousness as well. Jazakallahu khair once again for listening. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.
Takbir, takbir, takbir.